fix my hair every morning. You think I do that before I turn on the camera? I'm Barbara. It is April 24th. It's Friday. My first drink of coffee. I just got up. It's so interesting to me how different vlogging is from podcasting. You wouldn't think it would be very. And I suspect from when Leslie does it, it's probably not so different because she does her podcast by having, you know, by filming things all through the month and then putting them together into the podcast. Oh, the Avino's back. See there, you know, I want to make my place look nice for you so you don't have to look at the Avino. So I suspect, you know, well, you know, putting a video up every day is different than one video. My podcast yesterday was an hour, so it takes a lot longer to process. And I edit it. I don't edit this, and that makes a difference too. But anyway, for Leslie, it may not seem so different, but for me, for some reason, it seems really, really different. And I was always rambly on my podcasts and telling you stuff, so, but I tell you every stuff every day, so not so much left to talk about on the podcast, although apparently for an hour I did. I hope, I mean, I did put a disclaimer that the rest of this is about poker, in case anybody, you know, just fair warning. So that was the story of my poker. Sometimes I miss poker. I mean, I've played poker a little bit since that, since Black Friday. Because Pennsylvania changed their game, you know, they changed their gaming law several times and they added their first foray into gambling was that racetracks, which are already regulated for gambling, could have a casino if they wanted to. You know, I mean, they had to get a license and do the whole thing. So the first casinos were associated with racetracks, but they could not, they could only have machines. They could not have gaming tables. So no poker. So it was all slot machines. They might have been able to do some sports, but I don't think so. I think sportsbook came later. But anyway, but they had to be associated with a racetrack. So all the racetracks around added a casino. And Harrah's built a racetrack and a casino. Which I thought was pretty funny. And then some years later, they changed the law so they could have table games. And then they changed the law again so that you didn't have to be associated with a racetrack. So there are now freestanding casinos around the state. And in fact, there's a big building going up right at the Turnpike exit where I get on my way to State College, which is only 20 minutes from my house, that I believe is going to be a casino. But Parks Casino in Eastern Pennsylvania. I don't know the town, but it's right off the turnpike going the other way. In fact, I think they added a turnpike exit because of that casino. has a really, really nice poker room. And I've played there a few times. I came in third at a tournament there a few years back. It was the last tournament I played there. And I played some, you know, when I get an urge, but that's been a while. And, you know, every time this poker money comes from the same, you know, it's allowance. Poker's allowance, though. So's yarn. Only if you, you know. So, anyway. So that was the story of my poker. But I don't know. It's a very dreary day. And it's rainy, and you see that shine back there? That is the mud. That's the mud being made. We are going to be muddy soon. We are going to be muddy soon. Maybe spring has sprung. Our weather guy says we're going to have dreary, chilly, you know, sunny, chilly, chilly summer. No spring. That'll be too bad. That'll be too bad if we don't have a nice spring. I do look forward to sitting on my deck with my coffee in the morning. I was looking forward to taking, you know, to talking to you from my deck. Who knows how long I'll be talking to you. I mean, I know I'll be rambling, but I mean, like, how many days? I just saw the apple blossoms out my bedroom window. They're going to open soon. So I lied to you. When I showed you that little lime, it wasn't a lime. It was a flower coming. These are Dennis's lime trees. He's going to put those in pots. But he has, I may have told you this. Oh my gosh, I'm going to be repeating myself. I'm going to be like your, you know, senile old aunt who tells you the same story every day when you visit her. But Dennis has planted apple trees on our property. And some of them are getting pretty big. We have one big apple tree out the front. In fact, they're too big. Because you couldn't reach the apples. We would have to get, I don't even know. He's got a gizmo he thinks could pick apples. But we don't know for sure. Because all these apple trees, we have apple trees on this property. And they get beautiful in the spring. Get, you know, apples most years. Get, you know, they get the apples about this big, tiny, green, soury. And then they're gone. We have a squirrel who likes unripe apples and for his supper in the winter. We have literally gotten two apples in the 15 years we've had apple trees in this yard. That might be exaggeration. It might be only 12 years. The two apples is not an exaggeration. 1 year. And I know I told you this. I was looking out the window in the bedroom, and there was a red really high up. I'm like, either, and of course apples ripen in the fall. I said, either you've got a really red leaf or the squirrel missed one. And of course the ridiculous thing is that he's just planted. He's gotten these tiny little sticks in the mail of different kinds of apples, and he's just planted them over at the property next door for our future. But we can't eat apples on our diet. But the reason I was telling you was the flowers, because we also have a peach tree, and the peach tree is so beautiful to, and the funny thing is that peach tree got planted like in the wide space between our driveway and the driveway going up to our neighbors. And it's a little bit of a shady spot. I mean, it gets some sun, you know, in the afternoon, but it's not right out there in the middle. So he planted this peach tree at least 10, 12 years ago. It has hardly grown. It is still, I mean, it looks like a two-year-old tree, but we've had it at least 10 years. But it is full of flowers, and it's so beautiful. And he takes care of that tree. He goes out every spring. And he picks, you know, flower buds off or peach buds off that tree because it's not a big tree. So it can't support nearly as many peaches as it tries to. So he goes out and plucks it so that there aren't too many peaches on it. And we have gotten peaches off that, which are also not on our diet. But peaches come into season like at the end of August, September, I'm not sure. Seems like we're often away at, you know, we decide that peaches are ripe when the wasps start going for them because wasps like them really sweet. And we were going away. I don't know if it was last year or the year before, and we were going away and we told his parents, you know, keep an eye on these peaches because these peaches are going to be ripe when when the wasps go for them, come over and just take them all off the tree. And so they came over and they checked it. They thought, oh, you know, two more days, you know, it came back 2 days later, not a peach on the tree, all gone. So, but nothing on the ground to, like it wasn't like the deers came there and just were eating peaches unless they eat them whole. So I don't know. The squirrel might have decided he wanted ripe peaches in his nest, or the neighbors might have said, hey, they're gone, let's eat these peaches. We don't have that kind of neighbors though, so I don't even know. But they were gone, so they didn't get any peaches. We've gotten a few peaches over the years, and they were really good. But so we aren't, he's not planting any more peaches on the other property, but he is planting apples. I have a long history in his family of being big apple people. And I guess it's like, you know, his mother is Pennsylvania Dutch. I don't know if he would call his mother Pennsylvania Dutch or not. Probably not. But, you know, they all grew up around here and they all, you know, made things from scratch and things. Not that his mom's not a, is an extremely reluctant cook. She hates to cook and never liked to cook. And, you know, her mother was the master baker in the family. So Dennis's sisters and his aunt went over to his grandmother's. This was probably 15 years ago when she was still living in her little apartment. And they said, okay, grandma, we're going to make your special recipes and we're going to write them down because we want to know how to make these things. And, you know, her different kinds of rolls and different kinds of cookies and, you know, breads and all kinds of stuff, you know. And she'd say, oh, put in two cups of flour. And they put in 2 cups of flour and, you know, start mixing. Nah, that's not right. That's not right. Put another cup of flour. But, you know, so anyway, they have some semblance of recipes from Dennis's grandmother. But his mother's not much of a cook. She, you know, doesn't want to be a cook. But I guess they made stuff out of apples. I mean, she makes apple sauce. My mother-in-law makes apple sauce. She makes apple salad. She makes apple this, apple that, apple crisp. I don't know. They have to have apples. They buy apples by the bushel. You know, that was... So apparently Dennis needs apples too. We haven't eaten an apple in months. So. But they keep... When the apocalypse comes and there's no stores open anymore, that apocalypse, we'll have apples if it happens in 10 years. Anyway, I worked on my, well, that was a shit idea last night. It made me smile. And maybe I'll rummage on the website and see if I can find a Quaker sampler kit that I like. So I don't have to. Although, kitting it up is not going to be that hard. It's just all the same color. I mean, you want to kit it up when it has 47 gajillion colors, you know? So, but but I'm not going anywhere. I don't even know if we'll walk the dogs today because of the rain. Although Maisie doesn't care. She's out there. She's out there getting wet. She likes the rain. She's a water dog, poodle, Newfoundland, both water dogs. She doesn't care. Pearl won't go out. I mean, she might reluctantly go out and pee in the backyard really quickly, we hope. Although I'm lying like a dog. Pearl's out there. But she's on her way in. Maybe she peed already. Good. Anyway, I'm having a quiet day today. Dennis is nagging me to make some cookies. He made some white chocolate. So maybe I'll make cookies today. But I'm not promising that if I don't make cookies. Oh, I'm wearing my cozy Karina that I told you about, but I'm also wearing my Letterpress cowl. This is a cowl by Sara Bauer, and it has this wonderful braid. It's a giant cable around the neck, and then it goes down. I really like this. I wear this. It's almost like jewelry. Of course, partly because of the colors too, but different textures. So it's great. This is from I made it with a mini skein. I really like it. Sara Bauer. She's Sara Pomegranate. On the Yarns at Yinhu podcast. It's a audio podcast. She's lovely. And I really like this. And I just needed just a little more. And I didn't want to fuss with the shawl. That's what nice thing about a cowl. You don't have to fuss. Put it on. It's like putting on a little bit of a turtleneck and you're good. So that's what I'm wearing. And I hope you have a great day. I hope you are well and things are going okay. It's so hard out there. So many people filing for unemployment. It's just heartbreaking and mind-boggling. But I hope you're safe and I hope you're sane. Stay safe and stay sane. And I'll talk to you tomorrow.